phone was ringing. Somehow I knew the call was for me. The man had said Caldera Street Station. I had to go there. The Caldera Street Station sign was there, but the entrance was missing. I had to make it appear. Maybe I could use the lamp to reveal the station entrance. The lamp was dead in my hand. I needed to find a light for it.
Casey! Damn it.
I remember dying in this alley in a dream I had. He was just gonna keep killing me here, loop by loop. You're not gonna get what you want. You think you know. You know shit. You don't really wanna know. You're gonna get what's coming to you.
This was an echo of the books I had written for years. Picking up Casey's gun felt like I was assuming the role of the detective. I had a light now. I needed to get back to the subway station entrance. There was something hidden here. Light would reveal it. A phrase repeated over and over. The words resonated with meaning. Had I written this?
Shit.
With the alley in darkness now? Restless shadows blocked my way. Use the light to open the subway entrance now. I needed to find another light to go deeper inside. written books about Alex Casey for years.
Spring tried to wash away the sins of this city. But some sins, the evidence of the crimes committed, could never be erased. Not by the rain, or any amount of therapy from Dr. Jack Daniels. It remained bruises under my skin, like tattoos. Bruises in my soul. Scar tissue on my heart. The rain never stopped falling.
Hello.
Oh. Hey, Alan. You snuck up on me. See you around, Alan.
Found it awake.
The gates to the platform were closed. I had a ticket. Something about the station platform felt significant. It would work in my writing, but I needed more. Something lingered here. A half-forgotten memory. An echo.
An FBI agent had come here before me on the trail of a murder cult. He'd gone missing, presumed dead. The cult was leaving me clues to follow, connecting the dots from one murder to the next, inviting me to draw an obscene picture on the city map. Caldera Street Station. The name made me think of the exit wound of a bullet.
I had a flash of inspiration. The ghost of my fictional detective. A story thread I could use in my writing. I had a location. The dark place reacted to my story. The way into the tunnels was no longer blocked. The tracks led into the tunnel. That was my way forward. The blood trail continued deeper into darkness. Out of that. The tunnels were a maze. The blood trail led me on. Another place to use in this story. I needed to search the tunnels for further visions, inspiration for the story that would lead me deeper. I had a new location for the story. Had come here looking for answers. All he found was a fate worse than death.
It's bad luck to be on this case. The cult can get you anywhere with that black magic shit. Let the day shift handle it. What happened, anyway?
Some fed came looking for the cult, but it was a trap. A satanic blood sacrifice.
Anyone who gets involved with the cult, they're next. I heard their leader is this famous writer. Alan Wake? Their unholy motherfucking messiah.
Sounds like a load of bull.
The blood trail disappeared under the rubble. I had a feeling something was waiting there. Another echo lingered here. A source of inspiration.
Help me, ma'am. What do you know?
There's more than one urban legend about the Cult of the Word. The murder cult used these tunnels for their ritual sacrifices. They say the cult reenacted the murders in Alan Wake's crime books. That Wake was even involved somehow, under a false identity. Mr. Scratch, which is, of course, a nickname for the devil himself.
It was disturbing finding myself in the story this way. But I was desperate, and it felt right for the story.
Wake
The water was gone. The way forward was open.
Sorry. Have we met?
Memory problems again, huh? Yeah, we've met. Tim Breaker. We've shared notes. Hey,
You're making a map.
Trying to. It's hard to map a dream, though. Well, that's my crazy wall. I'm just trying to make sense of things. Don't judge me.
I'll trade you walls any day.
The train blocked my way forward, but it was here for a reason. It had a role to play. The plot element I found would drive the story forward.
Hello? Anyone there?
Dead. The story thread felt right here. The cult poured the gasoline over the train car. An iron cage.
This is where the history of the cult gets genuinely disturbing. The cultists track down the torchbearers living in the tunnels. They lock the poor folks up in a derailed subway car, douse it in gasoline. Yeah.
Charming.
It turns into a bit of a ghost story after that. They say the dark smoke from the fire still roams the tunnels searching for new victims to devour.
There are no happy endings in this city.
The story thread felt important. I could use it in one of the scenes I'd found. I had a new idea, a new story thread. A sick and twisted story. But it worked. The subway car had become a burnt husk. I could get through it now.
Fuck me.
Was blocked. I had to find a way through. The lights would help me. The Echoing Hall had a story to tell. I had a new scene to use, a new setting. The hall had changed into the murder cult's hideout.
Witnessed something here that made him run scared. Whether the summoning ritual had been a bona fide supernatural event or the mass psychosis of stark raving lunatics, it didn't change the facts. The cult was messing with things no one should mess with.
The ritual was a vital part of the story, the key to reaching the murder site.
going. Using the tunnels. Hidden graffiti signs mark secret routes. I kept hearing whispers around burn barrels of an underground society of mystic outsiders with hidden knowledge. Typical New York. Wake. Wake. My melon wake. Get out of my stone!
I couldn't hear the dark presence. It was gone. The tunnel was open now. I could get through. I had seen it before. I remembered now. It was always out there, hunting me.